welcome to worship with us at Coventry City Choir. This, of course, is our first Sunday in Advent, and so you will see that we already have our first candle lit on the wreath. We're going to take for our themes throughout Advent each of the candles and what they symbolise. And this first candle, and so this first week, we think of hope, everlasting hope. But during this service, we're going to share in a Christingle. And we've already given you a warning about that last week. So you will need an orange, a small candle, some red ribbon or sticky paper or whatever you can find, and four cocktail sticks and some soft sweets or some dried fruits like sultanas. And hopefully as we go through this morning's service, you along with us will build up and make a Christingle that you'll be able to then light in the coming days. But first of all, as we think about the light of our first candle, we're going to sing together, "The Light Has Come." Let's sing. Shall we pray? Lord, we thank you for this wonderful time of year and the preparations that we will be making physically, but also spiritually throughout the weeks of Advent. We pray that we will keep our focus totally on you, and that with all the joys and the bustles and the preparations and the plans and the things that might be a little bit different this year, we just ask your blessing, Lord. And we ask that we would remember the true meaning of Christmas. Please bless all those who need you especially just now. We remember those who are ill, those who mourn, those who are struggling financially, and those who feel perhaps they have no hope. May they know you and your presence with them each, bringing to them all that they need at this time. And continue to bless our worship this morning, Lord, and may it bring blessing to your heart also. For we ask it in your name. Amen. Amen. Now we're going to hand over to Hayley right now. They've been celebrating their 20th anniversary at Yule Court Care Home, the Salvation Army Care Home here in Coventry. Hayley is the chaplain there and she's going to share with us just now.
Last Saturday we had our 20th anniversary of the dedication of Yule Court on the 21st of November 2000. The land was donated and the home built with funds from Alfred and Valerie Yule. The first manager was Major Colin Edwin. Major Christine Edwin was the support services manager. I am one resident of the many happy to call the Royal Court my home. Please now enjoy two videos from the celebration.
We will now move into a service and a time of salvation for 20 years faithfulness of God to all those who have worked and lived here and continue to do so. We will now start by singing Praise My Soul.
Which is in your order of service.
Yeah. In your order of service.
Society. Nita Kua. Karabuna ye. Nanda Deja Society.
Sorry, for those that don't speak Swahili, I love him better every day.
Suffering and shame, and I love the cross where the dearest and best for a world of lost sinners was slain. So I'll cherish the old rosy cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown. Oh, that old rugged cross, so despised by the world, has numerous attractions for me. For the dear Lamb of God, let His glory above to bear dark Calvary. So I'll cherish the old cross till my trophies at last I lay down. I will cling to the old rugged cross and exchange it someday for a crown.
Come here. For thy mercy and thy grace, through another year, hour by hour of dark and thankfulness, Jesus, our Redeemer, is where? Here. Hallelujah.
We now come to the first part of our Christingle this morning. And this is the orange, and the orange represents the world and creation. And so Kat and Benjamin are going to read a poem about the creation story just now. And once they've done that, we're going to listen to the International Staff Songsters as they bring to us that John Rutter song, Look at the World.
Day one.
Brought heaven, earth and light. It must have been so very bright.
Day two.
God made the clear blue sky a place for many birds to fly.
Day three.
Brought land apart from seas, with all the plants, grass and trees.
Day four.
Shone forth moon, stars and sun. The work of God was not yet done.
Day five.
We see the fish and birds. God did all of this with just his words.
Day six.
God formed all beasts and man to finish his creation plan.
Day seven.
Was especially blessed, a day for worship and for rest.
All around.
we now come to the second part of our Christingle, and we're building it up gradually, and this is the candle that is needed. And if you're children, you may need some help from an adult to make a hole so that the candle can be placed within the orange. So we think of the orange as the world. We think of the candle as Jesus, the light of the world. And he said, and we find his words in John chapter 8, verse 12, I am the light of the world. And so that's what the candle represents there. Jesus, the light of the world, at the center of the world. And we thank him for the light that he brings to our lives each day through knowing him. So we're going to sing together the song, Light of the World. And of course the chorus says, Here I am to worship. Let's sing.
So the third part of our Christingle this morning is the red ribbon or some red tape, whatever you've got, that represents the blood of Jesus and the sacrifice that he made for each one of us. And it seems right that it's wrapped around the world because he died for the whosoever, didn't he? So that's what you need just now, some red ribbon, some red tape or whatever you've got that's red to wrap around the orange to represent the blood, like I say. And then we're going to listen to a recording of our own band who are singing that, that lovely song, When I Survey, reminding us once again of that ultimate sacrifice. So let's listen to that just now.
When I survey
Christingle is the four cocktail sticks with sweets or dried fruits on that remind us of the four seasons. So all through the year, summer, winter, spring and autumn, we have God's provision. His goodness is given to us in plentiful supply. And when we think of the world, there is enough food, there are enough resources for everyone on the earth, but it needs sharing. And I can't help but think that when we look at the provisions that we all have from God, how his heart must break when he knows that parts of the world are starving and yet other parts of the world are throwing away food and provisions. It's not right, is it? And so the lesson I think we need to learn from this part of the Christingle is that God's love, as Andrew said, is for the whosoever. He came for us all. He came to provide us all with his love and his provision. And we need to thank him for that, but always be ready to share. We're going to sing together that lovely song, Have You Ever Stopped to Think How God Loves You? And in verse 3 it says, everything is changing in the world today, but there's one thing reliable in every way. Other things may alter, but it's clear and plain that the love of God is just the same. His provision is always there.
Now we turn to our Bible reading. It's from Isaiah chapter 60, and Mark is going to bring that to us just now.
Our Bible reading this morning is taken from Isaiah chapter 60, verses 1 to 3. Arise, shine, for your light has come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. See, darkness covers the earth, and thick darkness is over the peoples, but the Lord rises upon you, and his glory appears over you. Nations will come to your light, and kings to the brightness of your dawn. Amen.
This morning we celebrate the first Sunday in the Advent season. And the first candle upon the wreath here symbolises Jesus Christ, our hope. Let us all look forward to this Christmas season, mindful of the truth that Christ is our hope. People need hope during these times of darkness, and especially now in these different, difficult times of separation and isolation for so many of us. And Christ was the hope of a world that sat in darkness for many years without hearing the voice of God. But because of the birth of Jesus coming into the world, that brought to us hope. Are you aware of everything that took place in Israel during those silent years between the Old Testament and the New Testament? The blessings of Isaiah 60 are that a world that sat in darkness without hope will find hope. The hope that we find in Jesus. And throughout his ministry, Jesus Christ brought hope wherever he travelled. He brought hope to the aged temple watchers when presented at the young age of just 8 days. We find that in Luke 2. He brought hope to the woman at the well in John 4. He brought hope to Mary and Martha when he raised Lazarus from the dead in John 10. We also know through Scripture that Jesus Christ is coming again, it says. But hope is temporary. For instance, when my beloved team, Leeds United, are due to play, you know, I hope and I keep hoping that they will win the game. And when they do, that hope is fulfilled. But on the day that we stand before Jesus Christ and see him face to face, our hope will be fulfilled. We will then know him as he knows each of us. We will stand before the hope of all mankind, and he will be more than our hope. He will be our intimate friend, brother, our saviour, our Lord, the one who gave his life so that we might have eternal life. So finally, I pray that the theme of this morning service, everlasting hope, will be your rallying cry this Advent season to everyone you come into contact with who may not have much hope. Their hope is in Jesus. Psychologists tell us that Christmas season can be the most stressful time of the year. Now, I doubt we really needed a psychologist to tell us that, particularly during the most challenging Christmas time ever, we need that advice. But there is hope in Jesus. Take that message to the single mother who cries herself to sleep at night, praying that God will take care of her and her children. To the stressed father who is trying so hard to provide for his family. We have a message to proclaim, and that is, there is hope in Jesus. To the lonely widow who celebrates each Christmas after saying goodbye to her dearest on earth. When the night seems too long and you awake to a dreary day, don't lose hope. There is hope in Jesus. If you are fighting a battle of fear and it seems that God is silent, just hold on. When your heart is broken in two and you are standing in the rubble of your life, God's word says, "Hold on, my child. Your weeping only lasts for a night. Joy comes in the morning." There is hope in Jesus. Will you acknowledge Jesus as your Saviour this morning, and this Advent Sunday celebrate for yourself the everlasting hope? Let us pray. Lord, today, as we focus on hope and how we receive this through our relationship with you, maybe we also be mindful of those who continue to walk in darkness because they refuse to acknowledge you or fail to trust in you. Lord, may your light shine brightly through each of us so that they too can know personally the hope that we share in Jesus. We pray all of these things in and through your precious name. Amen. Amen. And now we come to our final carol this morning. And it's that carol, "Come Thou Long Expected Jesus, Born to Set Thy People Free." And the second verse reminds me of the hope that we speak of this morning. "All thy people's consolation, hope of all the earth thou art, dear desire of every nation, joy of every longing heart." Let's sing this carol together just now.
we have our completed Christingle before us. Some of you may have already lit the candle. That's entirely up to you. I don't know whether there's any rules about this. I do know that some people keep it for Christmas Eve. Others will keep it and have it in the centre of their Christmas Day meal. But you do with it as you will, remembering the hope that the light of the world brings to each one of us. Now, shall we pray? Let's pray together. May the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace as you trust in him, so that you may overflow with hope by the power of the Holy Spirit. We ask this prayer in and through the precious name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. And God bless you all.
Snow is falling all around me, children playing, having fun. It's the season of love and understanding. Merry Christmas, everyone. Time for party and celebration. People dancing all night long. Time for presents and exchanging kisses. Time for singing Christmas songs. We're gonna have a party tonight. We're gonna have a party tonight. I'm gonna find my girl underneath the mistletoe, kiss by candlelight. Room is swaying, records play.